J-Man the Vanderwall fan back at it again with another video. As always, I want to welcome all my fellow Vanderwalls as well as any guests, especially those who might be discovering Grace for the first time. If that is you, you are in for a treat today. Why? Because it is Grace Vanderwall and you're always in for a treat. It's weird. We're going to be checking out the next song in our run through Stargirl's original soundtrack. Aside from internet issues, I wasn't feeling good at all yesterday. After I made the one video I made yesterday, I passed out. I couldn't take it anymore. I just was not feeling well. I don't know if you could tell in the video or not. I felt like crap. So today I feel much better. So we're going to play some catch up today and do some things dealing with Stargirl. And hopefully I can get you reviews on Hollywood Stargirl. But I'd like to do a double review on Stargirl and Hollywood Stargirl. But I need to kind of watch Stargirl again. And there's a documentary to talk about. Don't know if I'll get all that today, but this week will be a week that I'm going to get to all that for sure. Starting next week, there will be scheduling. We'll start scheduling my episodes to premiere at certain times. And I'm okay. So, where was I? Oh, yeah. Make sure we're checking out the video of the week. Today's, today and tomorrow. Just today. Well, you do any day you want to. Every day of the week's fine with me. But today's last day of the me pushing the video. So let's get over there and check it out. Today and Tomorrow's the name of the video by Grace Vanderwall, written for the first Stargirl movie. Let's show her some love. Show the girls some love because, oh, hey, Grace. And just, you know, be cool. Hey, Frankie. They become friends of mine. I don't know. Heaven knows. Ah, see what I did there? That's the song for this, this episode is Heaven Knows. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So. Let's just get into it. I don't know. I'm just ready to listen to some music and Grace Vanderwall's music at that. All right. How do we do this? Spacebar?
Can't tell this story alone.
That voice, I tell you, man. There's nothing she can't make sound beautiful. Not that that song wasn't beautiful as it was, because it definitely was. But my God, that voice. He's got, as I said in the documentary, a multi-generational voice, man. I mean, it's just so unique and beautiful. It just blows me away that. I mean, I guess it's what it took to get me over here. You know, I mean, let's face it. You all know I don't dig on singers. I just don't. I just never have. It's just never been my thing. And for a singer to pull me in like Grace has, it's definitely not. I mean, don't get me wrong, the songwriting is phenomenal in this Grace verse, but it was that voice that brought me in. Don't get me wrong, I don't know my name brought me in, but it was the voice, man. It was the voice. The songs just kept me coming back for more. It was that voice that brought me in, hands down that voice. And there's just no, you, she cannot, she just cannot do wrong. There's just no doing wrong for Grace. I mean, as I said before, chronic constipation, need I say any more? She just, the girl literally cannot go wrong. There's nothing she can do wrong singing wise. I mean, she may, even when she's flat or sharp on a note or completely misses the target, it doesn't really matter because her voice makes up for it. My opinion, I know not everyone's going to agree with me, but let's be honest, her voice is so incredibly beautiful, and then how do you top that? How come there's so many artists out there, okay? There are so many artists out there, and a lot of young female artists today. I mean, a lot of young ones, and they all have beautiful voices. I mean, don't get me wrong, they all have beautiful voices. They're all fantastic singers. There's nothing wrong with any of them. But then you have Grace. Grace Vanderwall puts to shame the most seasoned of singers I've ever heard in my life. Puts them to shame, just the tone of her voice. Forget the way she does it, just the tone of her voice. Everything about this girl's voice is just the most beautiful thing on planet Earth. Just listening to her talk is all you gotta do. If I ever hung out with her, that's all I'd just be like, whatever you want to talk about, you just talk. Just talk. I don't care. Just say something. Just say stuff. Just talk. But again, as I've said before, I would love to have a conversation with her because she's such an intelligent person, and I know she'd just be an absolute blast. Just 1 hour of conversation with her would be just the most amazing thing that could ever happen to me. Just 1 hour of nothing but conversation, whatever she wanted to talk about, I'd be interested in. But it'll never happen. It's what it is. I don't. I'm not like gonna die regretting that I never had that opportunity, or sad that I never had that opportunity. I mean, would it be nice? Yeah, I'd love just 1 hour, one single hour in a room with her talking, nothing else, just talking. And I feel like I'd be enlightened. I feel like I'd walk out of that room smarter than when I went in. It'll never happen. I will. That's just the way it is. It's the name of the game. But nonetheless, I mean, honestly speaking, I'm a 40-year-old man who has a reaction channel dedicated to her. How, you know, to her, how much creepier can you get? I don't know. Even though that it's not my, you guys get it. I know you do. But anyways, I love the song. I love her voice. Her voice sounds so incredibly beautiful in the song. It's just, she's, if you all have noticed this, especially all the ones that have been around from the beginning, you all have noticed that her voice morphs. It literally can, she can sing any style she wants to. And I've never seen that before. I've never seen somebody that can literally sing any style they want to. She is so flexible with her voice. It's almost like, how do you do it? I mean, how do you do it? I'll tell you how she does it. She's just that good. I feel privileged to be here on this planet at this moment in time. I feel privileged that I got to see her walk across that stage before something tragic happened to me. I feel privileged that she exists and that she's putting out music and that she's changing the face of music one song at a time. And I feel honored that she has brought so many people together who do not know each other. Look at us. The people that are always in my comment sections, look. Just look down there and see what we say, you know, to everyone else. You know, see what we talk about. I mean, she is unified. That's probably not the word. She has undeniably unified us. Would that be right? Unified us in a way. Is that right? That doesn't sound right. I think it's right. In a way, she's brought us all together. And to talk about her, you know, to say how much we adore her music and her acting and her anything she does, pretty much. I mean, the interviews and everything. It just does not matter what she does. We're going to accept it. Again, chronic constipation. Need I say more? If you were to have any other artists write a song like that, they would get absolutely smeared for it, because you do not, that's almost a taboo topic, talking about that kind of stuff. I mean, you can get away with maybe Rodney Carrington or something like that, but let's face it, there's just not many artists out there that can get away, just not many serious singers out there that can get away with it without pissing off half their fans. And who knows, maybe it did, I don't know. I think it's an amazing song, and the production on it is out of this world, man. I got two more breakdowns to do, by the way, just so you guys know. I'm going to be doing The City, and then I'm going to do Shitty Actress, and I just thought about that while it was on my mind. And then I want you guys to tell me, but we're going to put it in the comment section, though. I'll tell you, explain more when we get there, of what you guys want me to break down. But anyways, we got a lot coming this week, so hang in there, and hopefully it's going to be a fun ride. Hopefully we're going to, hopefully we'll get some new music really, really soon to be able to react to and listen to. Lion's Den, I'm really excited about that one. I'm hoping Need Me Now is on this new drop. Fingers crossed for Need Me Now. If Need Me Now is on this new drop, I will be the happiest person on the face of planet Earth, and it will literally be the greatest thing ever. But then again, Lion's Den sounded pretty damn good. I mean, I didn't hear much of it, but I heard enough of it to know that it's gonna be a damn good song. And then none of us heard, I mean, we all heard pretty much probably the same amount. And then whatever she has on there, I have a feeling that we're all going to love it. And none of us, at least that hang out in my neck of the woods over here, are gonna have anything bad to say about it or anything not super nice. A lot of fun things coming up with Grace VanderWaal, isn't it? Anyways, loved the song, loved her voice. If anybody knows who it's by, I didn't bother looking this stuff up, I just went with it. Let me know, and because I don't know. I heard of the Figured Out was the only song she wrote. That's all hearsay as far as I'm concerned. I have no idea. But it's a beautiful song, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. I think I don't know. This girl slowly just takes the words one by one away from me. There's just nothing you can do about it. She changes everything. Thank God. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it, and we will see you in the next video, and...